So yeah, good evening, yeah. So do I dare step away from the permaculture series? I know it's so exciting. I have a lot going on with it still in my head, but organizing, you know, fun things, because you know, people are gonna have llamas and yeah, that type of thing, you know. So that's when, in a way, you know, if you're making databases, that's when the databases can be fun. You've got the llamas and you've got all of the hens, but actually no, it's exciting to set up eco villages. Admit it, it's almost like a fun game, like makes all of this internet stuff just go away. We just don't even want to talk about it anymore and just make eco villages. But yeah, so tonight actually I was in this like weird, I got a Google account reminder again, and I'm like, uh-oh, I did something wrong. And I went through, and it's just like I was set at 1 month, and then I get ousted out of one of my accounts, and so I had to set it to 18 months or something. I mean, it's just like such an excessive extra that they're pushing on everybody, you know. And so, you know, because I have like maybe 5 or 6 accounts, and so I have to make sure every single one I've web surfed a little bit on each one, or I lose it. I lose that account. I mean, they have all these weird things. You have to sign in again, and that's not clear if it's a sign in or you can just keep your cookies. I, you know, so they just haven't made everything clear. And so it's just this vagary of, what's going to happen? Is all going to, you know, just vanish? And it's just such a hassle. It's just such a hassle, you know. Anyway, so I'm just like, I'm feeling kind of trapped, because we have like, I have all these telemarketers that call, and so we have to be put on the block list, and then there's this do not call list that's with the FCC, have to be put on that, so nobody can call, apparently, because I'm on the do not call list, but except for if you're in prison. I got a call today from a prison. So apparently those are the ones that are allowed to call, and they can bypass this FCC. It's very odd. I don't understand why prisons get through and telemarketers are still getting through, and why I've had to go through all of this incessant trying to sell things over the telephone to elderly people. You know, my dad, you know, could talk about illegal, talk about cheating an old man, attempts of cheating an elderly person, fraudulent investments, constantly calling every day. So I'm like, well, obviously, you know, when there are people are old, they're just preyed upon, yeah, because maybe they're lonely, they don't have anybody to talk to. They're like, yeah, okay, I'll talk to you. And it's just sad. It's a sad situation. Those people that prey on old ones, they should be shot. They just should be shot. When we talk about people that are shysters, we talk about people that go too far. Those people go too far. You know, try to steal from old people. Shame on you. Absolutely, you should be shot. You know, in the old days, you know, that just didn't happen. Those types of people did not exist. They really were. They were given firing squads, or they back in, you know, all of that. They just did not. We just didn't keep those types of people around. And it's just like, well, I guess they're multiplying or something, and we don't shoot them anymore. We don't, they don't do that alakazam and cut off their hands or whatever. And so right now, we're like looking at all of them just attack us in a way. And so I have to wait for my daily phone call from somebody in prison. And it's just like annoying. Because I'm never going to answer the telephone again. That's what it's put me in. I cannot even answer the telephone. So I'm in my own, like, well, what's the point of having the telephone at all? What is the point of having the service? And yet I have to have the service. So it's just become a what do you call it, a pest? It's become like a ping attack. Like you ping attack computers. It's just become an absolute bug, like a virus. So these people are like a virus. These invest in this and blah, 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 and we'll talk to you and you can buy these whatever, gold or silver, blah, blah, blah. Absolutely annoying. And I can't believe they even exist here in this United States and legally are getting away with it over the telephone lines. I just can't believe this. So what the heck? You know, it's total harassment. Total harassment. And how they can do this from prison, I don't understand. I don't get it. But when I look up the phone numbers, that's what I get. It's just like, oh, this came from blah, blah, blah. It's just like some correctional facility, another correctional facility, another correctional facility. And they're just constantly bombarding this house. So anyway, and yet they slither through the do not call. They slither through. So anyway, I'm just irked at the whole system tonight. You know, it's just like I'm going through the Google because I have to reset everything to make it 18 months. Oh, I get 18 months, you know, before they, you know, cut off the account. So I have this through. There it is at the top, Afghanistan. And that, and United States is like at the very, very bottom of the list. I mean, we know that. I mean, economically, we already know. Maybe you don't know, but yeah, it's not in good shape. So you have that constant reminder. Like, oh yeah, U.S., you really don't matter in the gist of it all. There's all those other countries out there. Just don't forget. But I mean, come on, harassment from Google. Even put it at the top. I mean, at this day and age, you know how to make a pull-down menu. You know how to list the United States at the top and just get it over with. You know that these particular IP addresses are located here in the United States. You can put the United States list at the top. You don't have to be such a pest with search through whatever Kuwait. You know, none of that has to go on. That's just like an extra 5 minutes every day that you just add into everybody's life that you didn't have to. So yeah. So when it which just says America at the top, it says America at the top. And just leave it. Whatever you guys call yourselves. Anyway. So yeah, I'm not having that great time getting these harassment phone calls. Yeah, it's a great, well, maybe mail. And then I'm like, that's what I was thinking about. I'm like, well, okay, so yeah, the only thing I have now is mail is an option. If people can contact me through mail, like the U.S. Postal Service. But then even that's like the weirdest thing ever because I went to the U.S. Postal Service and you can like change your mail address really easily. And there wasn't really a big check going on. And I'm just like, well, that looks like anybody could just forward my mail anywhere. So I'm like not trusting that either. So it's just like, so don't contact me, I guess. Nobody ever contact me because the mail won't work. It'll just be forwarded somewhere else. Or you know, it's, no, we only want her to get this particular mail and not that particular mail. And you know, I'm getting this like weirdness. And so I'm like, well, yeah, oh, that was strange. Also, when my father wasn't home, certain mail just did not arrive, any mail from the bank just would not arrive because my father wasn't home. This type of stupidity has been going on with the postal service. So they've been playing games on me that they would not even deliver his mail unless he was home, unless his car was in the driveway. And I'm like, well, okay, enough, enough. Everybody has apparently condemned me and put me on a judge jury situation. They've already hung me. They've already done an alakazam and cut off my hands. Whoever these people are can just go to hell. Absolutely go to hell. Okay. Alrighty. Ah. Just gotta get that out of my system. Anyway. Good night.